Hi, I'm Joey with this week's Science and Tech News. The United Nations Cultural Agency reported this week that a shipwreck found off northern Haiti is not the Santa Maria flagship from Christopher Columbus's historic voyage. Italian explorer Christopher Columbus sailed westward across the Atlantic Ocean in 1492 as part of an expedition for the Spanish crown. He traveled on three ships, the Santa Maria, the Pinta, and the Nina, hoping to find a profitable trade route shortcut to the East Indies. Contrary to popular belief, Columbus never landed in what is now the United States, and instead made several voyages to areas south and southeast of North America. The Santa Maria was wrecked on Christmas Eve in 1492 when a cabin boy ran it into a coral reef. Experts determined that the wreck near Haiti was not Columbus's ship by studying the area's geography, underwater terrain, and archaeology. Shrinking sea ice has forced thousands of walruses to crowd together, with an estimated 35,000 stranded 5 miles north of Point Lay, Alaska. See, these tusk-bearing creatures love to haul out, meaning they haul their body onto the ice to get nice and toasty from the sun. However, since the Arctic ice is getting too hot from global warming, it's melting away and leaving less places for the poor deers to soak up the rays. On Wednesday, a total lunar eclipse was visible at the same time as the sunrise in a rare phenomenon called a selenilion. A lunar eclipse happens when the moon is directly behind the Earth's umbra, meaning its shadow. A solar eclipse, on the other hand, is when the moon blocks out the sun completely by moving directly between its rays and the Earth. Unlike a solar eclipse, a lunar eclipse can be seen almost anywhere on the nighttime side of the planet. A selenilion occurs when the sun and moon are exactly 180 degrees apart, which would normally make it impossible to see both of them at once were it not for light bending along the horizon. Royal Air Force fighter pilot Andy Green wants to break the 763-mile-per-hour world land speed record set in 1997 by driving the world's first 1,000-mile-per-hour car. Five engineers worked 8 hours to outfit the Bloodhound SSC with an EJ-200 jet engine, which usually used in Eurofighter Typhoon jets. Green will make his world record attempt in the South African desert, where he'll drive the Bloodhound SSC down a custom 12-mile track. The Office of Naval Research has recently unveiled that the U.S. Navy is working on drone boats that can swarm enemy vessels. They're piloted by a sensor and software kit called Control Architecture for Robotic Agent Command and Sensing, which can detect potential threats from a warship before striking it as a swarm. The unmanned ships can also be remote controlled by sailors, providing a safe way to take out the dangerous foes.